Good people, welcome to the Save Happy Life channel with me, Dr. Rose M. And this channel discusses matters psychology and topical issues regarding psychological well-being of ourselves and those around us. Remember, I did a very interesting video on dementia, and after that video, I have been receiving numerous questions from people who are taking care of their elder patients or elderly relatives who have dementia. And today, I will look at only three of those questions in the interest of time. And the first one, I received it from a lady who told me that I stay with my mother who has dementia. Whenever she goes to the toilet, she unrolls the whole toilet paper and messes the loo in more than one ways. What should I do? She asked me. I told her, this is the answer. When somebody has dementia, it simply means that their capacity to think, their capacity to solve a problem, their capacity to be logical has declined. And as such, what she is doing in the toilet is the best she can think of doing. And it is so very unfortunate that that cannot be reversed. The only way to live with her is to know that that is the situation. That is the mental capacity of that mother. And to make sure that the lady goes behind her to clean up the mess. Something else, just to be a little bit proactive. If she needs to go to the toilet, to keep the toilet paper away from reach or away from sight of this patient. And that includes not just the toilet paper, but also the other items that normally are in the toilet. This is the toilet cleaning soaps and the air fresheners and anything else that this patient can reach. Question number two. My aunt suffers from memory loss on several occasions and has insisted on cooking food for the family with disastrous results, such as double salting the food, burning the food, and of course, increasing fire risks in the house. She insists that she must cook for her children. How can we stop her? This is my suggestion to you who may be having a dementia patient who is insisting on doing things that she or he used to do, but no longer has the capacity to do them, the mental capacity to do them. Whatever she can do, let her do it with your supervision, meaning you must be present wherever she is. She wants, like, for example, to peel potatoes, to cut the cabbage, so that you observe her and you make sure that you protect her from harming herself. On issues, lighting up the gas cooker or cooking for the family when she is left alone, you can disconnect the gas cooker so that she will try to light it up and it will not light. She may not have the capacity to think beyond just the lighting knob of the gas cooker. She may maybe possibly give up. Remember, we are dealing with a brain that is degenerating, a brain that is deteriorating. So my suggestion is supervision, supervision, supervision. Always make sure that a dementia suffering patient always has somebody who is looking after them. Question number three, and the last one. Our father has totally refused to shower. What should we do? This was in connection with another question from the same family, that my father takes animals to the river or my father recently took animals to the river and he left the animals on their own and went to the shopping center to buy himself a cigarette. After buying the cigarette, he proceeded home without the animals. So this family is asking, is our father's having dementia or what is the problem? Because he is refusing to shower. And on this occasion, he took the animals to the river to drink water and forgot about the animals. And all he remembered was his cigarettes, which he went to get in the shopping center. So what kind of behavior is this? My feeling on this issue is that this parent, this father of this family, is starting to experience decline in thinking and decline in problem-solving skills. And that is why there is the issue of taking the animals to the river and totally forgetting about the animals and proceeding to do something else that is totally different. And this is not unique to this person or to this patient. It is common, especially with dementia suffering patients. They do not many times want to shower. Best way, let somebody help them to shower, literally wash them, literally bathe them, because if they are left to themselves, you can be sure they will not do it. So let somebody do it for them in a loving manner. Do it for them in a way that they kind of don't command or don't tell the patient what to do, but rather do whatever they need to do for the patient and involve the patient in as much as the patient is agreeable, so that you do not make them get angry. We said in the previous video that they are easily angered, their temper is quite short, and now when the temper goes up or when they get annoyed, then they become a little bit difficult to handle. So my take on these questions today is these people, they need supervision. They need understanding from us, from you, who knows that their mind is declining, their brain capacity is declining. So it is up to us, up to you, who still have their mental faculties right, to make sure that you kind of get into the rhythm, get into the calendar, get into the timetable of these ones who are suffering. Remember, they do not know they have a problem. What they are saying and what they are doing, anything about them in their life is the right thing. It is us, or it is you, the caregiver, who can see that there are changes in their life. And wherever we have these patients, let us be patient with them and shower them with love, with compassion, with care. And at the back of our mind, always remember that this is not a problem that is about to go away. It can only get worse. And no medication stops. It only makes the patient comfortable. It only delays the degeneration process, but does not reverse it and does not stop it. So thank you very much for being with me. Let us continue taking care of these patients, because they need us. They need us. They need our love. They need our tender love and care. Goodbye, and please share.